zero and lift off.
When I saw the space shuttle launch over a decade ago, that was something that it was just a really moving experience. It's inspirational, it's emotional, and to get to see that accomplishment and now to be here working as a NASA engineer to send humans back to the moon and onto Mars. I am a wind tunnel researcher, I'm in the aerodynamics branch here at NASA Langley. So we study the aerodynamics as well as the heating environment of vehicles. So how do they fly and how do they survive along their trajectory, especially in the high-speed regime? And so we do testing for many different customers and programs within NASA. And one of those programs that I support right now is the Space Launch System, or SLS. So that is aerodynamic testing. So we need to know the aerodynamic forces on the vehicle so that we know, first of all, that it's going to fly correctly. It's going to get where we want it to go. And we want to make sure that the loads on the vehicle are going to be withstood by the material that the vehicle is made out of. After college, I decided to go to graduate school. It wasn't an easy path. I had some challenges during graduate school. Even though I really loved the material, I felt like some of the environments were really challenging for me as a female. And so I had considered other paths after graduate school, but never lost that dream of wanting to work for NASA. For me, coming here after my experience in graduate school, I was a little bit nervous about what I would find in such a technical field as a woman, but I have found that my work is very challenging. I'm surrounded by really talented and accomplished people that I enjoy working with, and I feel very respected as a technical professional. And so I think the environment here at NASA Langley, specifically the one I've been in, has been very supportive. And so I hope that we can maintain that. And what I see is that often still I might be the only woman or one of very few women in the room. Only 23% of our science and engineering workforce at NASA are women. And so that's a place where I'd really like to see some growth. And so for me, it's really important to get out in the community, to have young girls see that there are women, there are people that look like them that are pursuing aerospace engineering, and to get them to apply and to not give up and to keep working hard and pursuing that dream. And especially, you know, we really could do better for women of color. So even though if you look around the room and a lot of people don't look like you, that's okay. You want to get in that room so that you can inspire more people to be there with you.